So dear students, let's start reading next para of this lesson, page number 31, right? We have read till 6th para, and what was the last para? It was about that Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. You can see he found this beautiful waterfall as he was doing hard work. He was feeling very thirsty. He was in the need of water. So he was thinking about that, and suddenly he heard the sound. He went towards it and he watched, and he saw a beautiful waterfall. And yes, he tasted the water, but it was not the cold water, it was sake. And he tasted again and again, and it was a delicious sake instead of cold water every time. Alright, so let's start reading para number 7. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delighted with sake. So as you can see, he had a pitcher. Pitcher means a pot usually made of mud. All right. So you can see in the picture, he had a pot with him. So he filled this pot with this delicious sake and went back to home hurriedly, very quickly. And the old man was delighted with the sake. As his father tasted this drink, he felt very delighted. He was very happy. After, just turn the page number 32. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. Means as his father sipped or swallowed a drop of liquid, right? Means as he drank a little amount of sake, he felt happy and he stopped shivering. Means he was feeling very cold and he stopped shivering, right? And did a little dance in the middle of the floor. And to show his happiness, he did a dance, right? Where? In the middle of the floor. He started dancing in because of happiness as he stopped shivering, and he was very happy after having what? Delicious sake. Next, look at the para number 8 on page number 32. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. So, here is the word greedily, right? Which means as a desiring more and more. So what happened after having the liquid that afternoon, on the same day at the afternoon time, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. A lady came to visit them, right? So Taro's father politely, as obviously if someone reached at home and someone came to our home, obviously what we do? We offered what? We offer them some milk or some water, and we do hospitality. So similarly, in the same way, with a polite nature, with a polite manner, what happened? Taro's father offered her a cup of the sake, right? As he Taro brought a pot full of sake, so from that his father offered the same to the lady. The lady drank it greedily. Greedily means very hurriedly, as she was desiring more and more. So in this way, she drank the sake and thanked the old man. Obviously, she said thank you because the old man offered her the very expensive drink named sake. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Afterwards, what Taro did, he told the story about the waterfall. Means how he found the waterfall and there was no cold water. It was the sake, and he brought this drink from the waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. After hearing the story and drinking the sake, she was became very curious, and she wanted to know more about the waterfall. So she left their place in a very quick manner. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. As you can see, she visited in the afternoon, right? But till the night, as the night was approaching. Till that time, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. Means whole villages now heard the story of the magic waterfall only because of the lady. Now everybody knew about that. Number 9, that evening there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. So what happened that evening at till this time, as everybody came to know about the magic waterfall, then everybody reached near to their near to Taro's house. Procession of visitors, a crowd of visitors was there, and each man heard, because everybody heard the story and they wanted to taste that particular drink. So within in less than an hour, means it took hardly an hour to empty the pitcher, means everybody had tasted the drink, one sip or two sip, but every villager has had tasted the what? Sake. What happened next? 10. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jar, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and shouted angrily, "Water, nothing but water." Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. So what happened in the next morning? Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. Means he went to the forest earlier than the morning, right? Before the morning time, means it was the dark, before the sunrise, he went to the forest and he carried with him the largest pitcher he owned. All right, a day before he just brought a small pitcher, but as he wanted to bring more sake, so he took with him a largest pitcher which he could get at his home, for he intended means planned, because he was planning that first of all he went to the waterfall, there he filled the pitcher and returned it to come back to the home. But what he saw there, when he reached there, he found the waterfall. He found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. Then when he reached there, what he found? He found all the villagers present there. They were carrying pitchers, jar, buckets. Or you can see in the next page, a picture is given. All right, and you can see, here is Taro. Right here is all the villagers were there, and you can see the pitchers, jar, buckets, whatever they have in their home, they have brought with them because they all wanted to take that particular drink. All right, so back to the para 10. Anything they could find. Then one villager knelt and held his, as they heard about the sake. So what happened? One person knelt down and he wanted to taste the water. So as he tasted the drink, what he got? He was shouting because there was only water. He was shouting angrily, "Water, nothing water." He found only water. And again he was saying, others also tried. Then after that person, one, two, three, many other persons also tried, and everybody got only the cold water, not sake. Right? So look at the next page, page number 33, para number 11. "We have been tricked," shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock when he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. So what happened? Then all villagers were shouting. They were very angry because they were thinking that Taro had tricked him. Tricked them, because they have been cheated by Taro, because Taro told them the story about the waterfall, but they didn't get even a single drop of sake. So they were finding, they were asking for Taro because they wanted to drop Taro into this waterfall, because they were thinking he had cheated them. So, but as you can see, he was behind the rock. He was first of all standing there. He was looking at the conditions and he was wise enough to saw the things what were the going on there. So nobody could find him. Next, muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. So what happened? Muttering means speaking unclearly. Everybody was just muttering with angers and they were very disappointed. So what happened? They all the villagers left one by one that particular place. So afterwards, Taro came out from the from behind the rock, came out, and he also very wondered that was it a dream. Means he got obviously sake from this waterfall. So was it it had been a dream, because everybody was saying that it is a there were only cold water. So he was once more he wanted to taste it. So what he did, he just caught a little drop of water and tasted it, and again he was surprised. It was the delicious sake, nothing else. So to the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake. As he was very thoughtful son, he was doing hard work for his father only. He wanted to fulfill the wish of his father. So because he was very thoughtful son, and that's why he was doing hard work, the magic waterfall gave sake only to him, not to others. All right, so everyone else, it gave only cold water. All right, as nobody was like Taro, so the waterfall was giving sake only to Taro. Now turn the page number 34, last para. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This said the emperor was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. So what happened? As the story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached to the emperor of the Japan, who was the king of the Japan. So what he did? The king, what he did, he sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold. Means he called him into his palace and awarded him gold. And because he was very so good and kind, for having been so good and kind, he rewarded him. He also did one more thing. He just gave the beautiful fountain the name Taro. Right, because he was very thoughtful son and he wanted to encourage other children of his country. He wanted that other children took inspiration from him and and they learn how to honor and obey the parents, because obeying and honoring the parents are most important thing in this world, obviously. So he wanted to teach every children this lesson. So he named a beautiful fountain Taro. All right, and because of his thoughtfulness, because of his loving and kind nature, Taro became a famous person. Right, and obviously he got magic waterfall only because of his hard work only.